Attention game. And whoever wins and answers the question correctly will get 30 BCM, which is even coin. Alright, so the instructions are as following. Count how many times the player is wearing white, pass the basketball. So pay attention, you may be able to get some BCM. So, how many you got?
15.
14.
All right, remember your answers.
Nobody saw it win.
Nobody.
Yes.
The correct answer is 15 passes. Okay, so how many of you saw the gorilla? How many of you did not see the gorilla? So everybody saw the gorilla? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 did not see the gorilla. Statistically speaking, 50% of the people who did this test did not see the gorilla. I want to talk about this type of gorilla that we don't see when we're really focused on something and we have the goal in front of us. And there are many things like that in life, including the environment, animals, and even people. We live in a capitalistic society. We're focused on profit maximization in a purely competitive space. That's the definition of capitalism by Adam Smith. And I want to talk about the type of value that is clearly ignored in a capitalistic society. So, blockchain is called the Internet of Value. In a capitalistic society, value is something that is defined as profit or goods or services sold for profit. And I want to talk about value that is not part of that picture. So love has value, generosity has value, respect has value, freedom has value, truth has value. So what are we gonna do about those types of value? Can blockchain be used to move those types of value to the place where they're needed? And in other ways, is blockchain a perfect mechanism for a social enterprise? So it turns out that there are many blockchain projects launched in 2017 and 2018 in a pilot mode that have used these features of blockchain. Trust, transparency, programmable features of smart contracts, security, to actually achieve their goals, and they've done really well. So we're gonna go over 10 projects that I particularly like to illustrate how these features of blockchain are making real strides in social enterprise. First, let's review what a social enterprise is. Social enterprises are for-profit and non-for-profit enterprises that are slightly different from the traditional ones in a way that, one, the impact is measured by more than just revenues, number of clients, and profits. Two, they usually are concerned with the needs of a particular community. And three, they are trust is a very important component in the success of those projects. One of my favorite projects is Building Blocks. They're using iris scanning technology to identify refugees and distribute aid to them directly without using the banks. So that saved almost 100% on the transfer fees. Power Ledger was first Australia's ICO. This is Dr. Gemma Green, the founder of the project, together with Sir Richard Branson, of course. With Power Ledger, you can trade unused solar power energy, so you can save energy that you're using, and you can trade it with your neighbors. How cool is that? Kidner is one of my favorite projects. There are 130 organ transplants every year. About 70% of those are kidneys. Half of those are done from living donors. So many people are just waiting on transplant lists, 3 to 5 years. A lot of them die, 4,000 people in the US. A lot of them get too sick to be on the list, that's 3,000 people. And then dialysis is super expensive. It's $60 billion in the US alone, which is 30% of Medicare budget. When you look at this solution, you're thinking, wow, how come nobody has thought about that? And the answer may be, maybe this is only possible with blockchain. So let's review how this works. It's called kidney pair donation. So Dave wants to give a kidney to Carol, but he's not a match. However, he's a match to Alice. Bob wants to give Alice a kidney, but he's not a match, but he's a match to Carol. Ding, 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 we got a match, right? So because of blockchain, all of this is securely encrypted, and all of these people in the ecosystem only find out about each other when there is a match. There are over 2 billion people in the world that are currently unbanked, and apps such as Abra help them get access to cash flow, you know, getting paid for their work, even getting credit worthiness, you know, receiving credit, and basically increasing their financial inclusion in this world. Hypergive is a cool project that helps anybody donate food to those in need. A homeless person gives a business card with a QR code to whoever wants to donate. Those people go to a secure page and process their donation. A homeless person or a vulnerable person can go to a participating grocery store and check their balance and get whatever they need, including all kinds of restrictions that can be placed, such as daily spending limits and the types of products that they can acquire. Cool, right? CarbonX is tokenizing carbon offsets to satisfy global demand for sustainable products. Their zero footprint program evaluates the footprint of different sustainability projects and lets companies trade them. One in 10 people in the US get sick from a foodborne illness every year in 2018. How crazy is that? And 400,000 people die every year. So IBM partnered with a bunch of food giants such as Walmart, Unilever, Nestle, Kroger, Dole, and so on to create a global supply system, transparent, blockchain-powered chain where you can basically, where you will be able to check the status of food products all along the supply chain, including manufacturers, retailers, storage, distribution, and so on. And the goal, of course, is to be able to pinpoint any issues that will happen along the supply chain and then, you know, take those products off the shelves before the food illness spreads. In 2015, Deanne Kemp created Everledger, which allows to place diamonds on this global system and see their journey from the inception to the consumer, alleviating the problems such as fraud as well as the issue of blood diamonds. Over 1 million diamonds have been uploaded, and they have partners like De Beers, Barclays, and so on. So this is a successful project. ATEC was the first project to provide identity to refugees, to Syrian refugees in Jordan, and they also transferred funds based on the identity that they provided. Alice provides a smart contract-based system where NGOs get their funds based on the milestones that they achieve. So you can see where an NGO is at any point of their project, and you can donate on the basis of what they've done. Colo supports local communities by providing local currency. They've done successful projects in southern Tel Aviv, creating the local Tel Aviv shekel, as well as the East London pound. They've moved to Haifa and Liverpool and are soon coming across to your community to help local communities flourish and help anyone invest in their local community. Vegan Nation is creating Vegan Coin, helping vegans all around the world sleep more soundly by knowing that the money that they're spending and the products that they buy is 100% cruelty-free. The system incentivizes vegan businesses and participants in the ecosystem. It's a completely transparent system where you can see where everybody else shops, creating this kind of a traceability mechanism, similar to what IBM is doing, but more crowd intelligence. And this is it. This is the 10 projects that I wanted to talk to you guys about. We're creating several things right now in addition to my hat, besides the hat in the Vegan Nation, is also the founder of Women in Block. It's an organization that's going to have our first meeting in the next 2 weeks, on the 26th of June. And we're going to create an association where women can advance in the world of blockchain. I'm also a board member at Blockchain Israel, and we're having a hackathon for social enterprise startups on the 12th of June. So anybody in that space, interested in that space, is welcome. So check out Vegan Nation. Anybody who got VCN right now, come up to me or sign up on the website, and you'll get it. Thank you.